This is courtesy of Vulture. Interesting development. So this is about the Grammys, right? Supposedly, I haven't even seen the whole list, but what is it? Marilyn Manson, Louis C.K., and I think Dave Chappelle, right? Have got nominations for their work, and I guess people are getting their panties in a twist because they thought all three of those guys were cancelled. So why are cancelled people getting awarded awards at these mainstream award ceremonies? You know, interesting question to have, but you know. Let's read. The Grammy CEO said he's sing. She said the following. As is the case every year, the 2022 Grammy nominations were full of some surprising names. From the 11-time nominee John Baptiste to the first-timers like ABBA. First time ABBA's been nominated for a Grammy. Okay. When people are complaining nowadays about Grammys, like, let's just continue. Selena Gomez. There was also names that made for more uncomfortable surprises. Dr. Luke, Marilyn Manson, and Louis C.K. Now, the Dr. Luke thing is interesting because after the allegations came out about him, was the sexual misconduct with an ex-girlfriend or something? I don't know. Didn't read too much into it. Don't really give a fuck. But the funny thing about it, all this virtue signaling, is that Doja Cat, I think there's a few tracks on her album. I'm not sure. Maybe it might be the one of the singles was produced by Dr. Luke after the allegations came out. And no one scrapped that. No one said anything. No petitions got done. So people are very selective with their outrage. If it's somebody they like, they don't have anything to say. If it's somebody they don't like, suddenly they have everything else to say. This is basically the name of the game. And you're going to see this common theme running through with something else I'm going to talk about later. But anyway, it continues here. Let's read that again. There were also names that made for more uncomfortable surprises. Dr. Luke, Marilyn Manson, and Louis C.K. Three men accused of varying forms of sexual abuse and assault. Dr. Luke's three nominations for writing and producing on Doja Cat's Kiss Me More and Planet Her Deluxe, as well as the Sweetie and Doja Cat Best Friend. He produced all those fucking hits, right? Were not his first since Kesha accused him of sexual abuse after he was nominated for Record of the Year 2020 for Doja Cat Say So. Again, has she said anything about it? No. Did she take that song off her album? No. Again, virtue signaling nonsense. But Mason's two nominations for writing on Kanye's Jail in Best Rap Song and CK's one for Sincerely Louis C.K., which is a fucking brilliant stand-up special. Maybe one of the better ones, actually. Especially considering how long he was out, you know, from doing stand-up and being prevented from going up on certain shows because people would boo or walk out of shows. The fact that he was still able to deliver that level of a stand-up special basically proves that he's a special breed. I mean, he's up there with the Dave Chappelle's in terms of freak of nature, in terms of stand-up. Him, Bill Burr, Dave Chappelle, they're in a kind of league of their own, really. It continues here, says, we're the first since the allegations. Addressing the nominations in an interview with Rap Recording Academy CEO Harvey Mason Jr. Ooh, he's got the first name as a Weinstein. It continues, said the Grammys won't restrict. There's an interesting point here. Harvey Mason Jr. said this, the CEO of the Grammys. They said, won't restrict the people who can submit their material for consideration. He continued, we won't look back at people's history. We won't look at their criminal record. We won't look at anything other than the legality within our rules. Is this recording for this work eligible based on a date and other criteria? And I think, in my opinion, that's how it should always be. Because what ends up happening is that if you want to be the moral police and if you want to have morality and ethics included in these sort of things, I'm all for it. Cool. But let's do it across the board. Let's not just do it to people we don't like. Let's apply morality and ethics to every single person that gets nominated, whether it's somebody you like or don't like. But no one wants to do that because if you do that, you're going to have some very uncomfortable conversations because some of your faves are included in those cancellation conversations. I mean, they should be included too. If you're going to cancel this person, you also have to look at that person for working with the person that you think might be cancelled. Those conversations need to be had as well, but people don't do that. People want to pick and choose who they want to cancel, which is why I think in general cancel culture is gay as fuck, and I absolutely hate it, because in my opinion I would much prefer we live in a world where we all decided as a society to say, you know what, we don't fuck with this guy because he said something that nowadays in society we don't like. And as a society, we decide that we don't want to back him anymore. And then if his career dies a slow death, it dies a slow death. In the question of the baby. If the baby's fans like what he still does and don't care what he says on the stage, they should still be allowed to go and see him on shows, see him at festivals and buy his stuff. without being shamed or whatever, mocked online, whatever. You should be allowed to still be a DaBaby fan and do your thing. And you should also be able to find his music easily. His music should be on playlists. It should be on the first page of the Discovery thing. All that sort of stuff should be allowed on his behalf because his fans are still backing him. But the grand public, they're allowed to say, we don't want to fuck with him. And if his career again dies, so if it does. But what we got nowadays is this institutional industry type cancellation where they decide to turn off your lights. They decide, the industry decide, hey, we're not going to allow you to eat. We're going to be the ones to turn it off. And then the vocal minority, you're not your fans anyway, they're the ones also keep continuing, cheering on the pylon, bringing out their fucking torches and shit, right? Ironically enough, and trying to light you up even more. That's what I don't like about it. Counterculture should work in terms of you taking personal responsibility to say, this what this person did, I don't like. So it's now tainted the art they produce. So I've taken a personal responsibility to not back anything they do. So I'm like personally deciding to cancel them because for me, they've crossed the line and I can't see them the same again. Cool, no worries. But then let the fans enjoy the music. The people don't do that though. They wanna police how everybody enjoy stuff. You can't enjoy this because of that. You can't enjoy that because of that. And it's just fucking bullshit. Because again, if we're going to do that, let's apply the rules for everybody the same, but we don't apply the rules to everybody. So I much prefer this. Now, if they stick with this, it's fine. Because it's easy to say this when it's Louis C.K. and it's Dave Chappelle and it's Marilyn Manson. They're all at the top of their craft, or they're all at the top of their industry or their genre, wherever, right? They're big stars. Most of them, or all of them, basically, have made it, basically, right? It's not as if this Grammy is really going to make any difference in their career. But will it be easy to do the same thing if it was like a 22-year-old guy? If it was somebody just coming up who didn't maybe have as much clout or maybe didn't have as much years in the game, would that be something they would do? Probably not. But still, I like this precedent being set. Let's keep all that stuff that happens outside of the art, outside of the art. Because if we start looking back retrospectively and we start punishing people for what they do, you know, outside of their basic, you know, skill set and talent, then we're going to have to go back to the history books and start taking away people's Grammys. Do you know what I mean? And no one wants to have that conversation. We continue. The question of if and how award ceremonies should be addressed problematic nominees has been haunting other shows for the past few months, particularly in relation to Morgan Wallen, the country star who said a racial slur in February. While shows like the ACMA Awards removed him from the contention, the CMAs, of course they did, allowed his albums and songs to be nominated to recognize his collaborations, and the American Music Awards kept him in the chart-based categories, but all said he would not be allowed to attend. What's the point? So you keep him there to bring the eyes there, to make it a good vibe, to obviously, you know, add to your show, but then he can't perform on your stage. Like, nonsense. Again, if you're going to cancel Morgan Wallen for calling his white friend a nigger, which is, you know, whatever, well, who knows what's going on over there, then just say he can't perform flat out on all your things. But again, they enjoy the ears and the eyes that he brings to their stations and their sister sites and shit, and they don't want to let go of that Morgan Wallen dough. So they continue doing this nonsense they're doing at the moment, and I absolutely hate it, man. I absolutely hate it. It's all selective nonsense. While Wallen's case is obviously different from the other nominations, so musicians accused of abuse and assault, and Wallen, who also is fully eligible and a zero Grammy nomination. Mason Jr. hinted at similar restrictions on attendance. He says, what we will control is our stages, our shows, our events, our red carpets. We will look at anyone who is asking to be part of that and asking to be attendance, and we'll make our decision at the point. So if you're a problematic person and you make good music, they're going to include you in nominations. But if you're problematic and you're trying to attend, you can't come. How does that make sense? Again, let's apply the rules all across the board. If you've got a couple of cases on you for, you know, domestic violence, and they decide that's where they end and you can't be considered for a nomination, then take me off the thing completely. Don't invite me, don't nothing. But don't say, yeah, we can recommend your music. So what? You're gonna play my music? You're gonna play music from a domestic? You're gonna play music from a woman beater, you know, in the intermission during the show's on? But you're not allowing me to set foot in there. What difference does that make? I'm still there. When my music comes on, people immediately think of me and what I've done and my actions because they're intrinsically linked. Just a whole bag of nonsense. But again, I prefer this stance because I think cancel culture is gay, and I'd much prefer we live in a world where we decide, we take personal responsibility and say, if we don't like some of what they did outside of their art, cool, we don't listen to them. But we also let others who enjoy that shit enjoy it. And we also try to live in a world where if we don't have nothing to say and we're indifferent, we just keep scrolling. I don't understand this whole engaging thing with stuff that you don't like. Like, if you don't like it, just keep scrolling. Like, I see plenty of stuff on Instagram that I don't like. I just keep moving. You don't go on there and leave a bad comment. You just keep it moving. Most people do. But for some reason, when it comes to these weird issues, people suddenly start to get on their soapbox. And to me, it seems a bit balmy army. But, you know, what can you do on that one? What can you do on that one?